stop to start the game. Lakers coming in here, by the way, on a two-game win streak. It all began with the highly publicized calling out of his teammates by Kobe Bryant following a power.
Kobe Bryant brushes the arm, makes it look like he didn't really touch you, the rookie scoring leader so far this season, and Andrew Wiggins has got the little advantage on Jabari Parker right now, and they've been kind of...
Johnson out of the corner, feeds it inside, and Davis able to drop it.
He's a really good player that plays the right way. He's going to pick you up full court, and that's one of the things that, and again, the pressure by Price creates the turnover.
Three on one break, puts it behind his back, extra pass to Johnson underneath.
Fiend, and all of a sudden someone else has to initiate. Sometimes that's just the easier thing to do.
Wiggins spins, got Kobe going the wrong, retake the lead. Timberwolves have won three straight in this series and four of the last five. Wiggins dropping it down. Wes Johnson. Jordan Hill left alone. He'll take it and make it. Gorgui the hand up for Zach LaVine. Trying to get it right back to him. A little bit sloppy on the pass. The Wolves fortunate. He's able to hold three now from the field in this game. Thad Young for Gorgui, the throwdown. An 8-2 run for Minnesota. Gorgui averaging just under 9 points and over 8.5 boards. Kobe will pass Michael Jordan, not necessarily if, but when he will pass Michael Jordan. Needs 9 points still as he's yet to score in this contest.
Nice.
Zach LaVine.
Nice.
Finding Kobe too much, but it was certainly appropriate in that situation. Bryant draws the double team.
Minnesota has been double-teaming and switching a ton, and really to their profit.
The thievery continues for Mr. Brewer. Thad Young, a little hesitation, then puts it on the earlier number one in scoring amongst rookies. He's sixth in rebounding, fourth in steals, leads all rookies in minutes this season. It's
no question.
Bryce leaves it short. Shabazz with the rebound. Brewer feeds it right back to Boz in the throwdown. Quiet, some Yahoos started yelling Kobe, but it was certainly something that brought a buzz to the
years, and for years to come too. He looks like he still has a lot left in the tank. He's only 36.
Went into the game against Oklahoma City having hit 27 of his previous 31 and then went 3 for 8. Or when we know more, but admitting that potentially it is going to be season ending for Roni Turiaf, but saying that that's not definitive yet, but the potential for that is certainly there. Kobe takes it down the part of the paint, unable to get it to go. It's putting her on him originally. Bennett trying to stop him. Nick Young a little bit strong. Rebound tapped out. Kobe able to track it down. Jeremy Lin goes in to chase Buttinger. No whistle. And Robertson.
Nice pass by Gorgui Dieng that Corey Brewer couldn't handle.
Numbers for the Lakers. 4-on-1. Carlos Boozer with the 5 has it just rattle off.
A lot of missed layups here last few minutes for Minnesota. Boz has missed a couple point blankers.
Nick Young for Kobe. Still sitting on the 4 points. Boozer sent out of there. Boozer sent out of there by Gorgui Dieng. Brewer looking to take it right to Jeremy Lin. Contact offense. Oklahoma City here at Target Center on Friday night. They throw it away. Jeremy Lin 1-on-1 against Zach LaVine. And LaVine to return the favor tonight. First bucket of the night for the Harvard product. Chase Buttinger.
Smaller than Andrew. Wynn goes about 6'5". Andrew's got about 3 inches on him.
We mentioned the Roni Turiaf surgery. Flip Saunders asked, does this mean Jeff Adrian will be staying around a lot longer? And he said, we'll see.
Just looks Timberwolves fans as well. I mean, I think he's done a great job.
8 points now in the game for Andrew Wiggins. Boozer dropping down.
He likes to reject the screen. When somebody comes and sets a ball screen for him, he tends to reject. Is that when you use the screen, a lot of times you get hedged, you get trapped sometimes as well, and it's a way to get to the foul line, and Andrew did a good job there.
Already 10 points for Wiggins, his 15th double-digit scoring night of the season, and they're starting to come with a lot more frequency. The Turnaround for the rookie. Rattles out. A little contact between Zach Gray and Bennett underneath, but no whistle. Nick Young. Young knocked. Boozer had a triple team, and the Lakers couldn't find an open guy quick enough. Levine the other way with.
So he slung that one through the halo.
First points of the night for Levine, who had 28 in Staples Center. 12% free throw shooter on the season. Jimmy talked about his prowess on the offensive glass. 55 from the field for Kobe. He does have a couple of free throw makes to tally into his point total. Shabazz gets.
They don't run that drop series as much for Shabazz as they do for Andrew Wiggins. Shabazz is built more, and Kobe Bryant time to get his hand up. That was so fast.
Kobe now just a single point behind MJ. Levine into the corner. Corey Brewer knocking 96, 1 point away from matching Michael Jordan for third all time. Not the pageantry most people wanted to see, but effective nonetheless, and appropriate because not only did his first point come from the free.
Get into any debate about who's better between Magic, Kareem, Kobe. He doesn't get in any of that conversation.
Shabazz Muhammad trying the game, studies the history of the game. Timberwolves get the turnover. Shabazz Muhammad putting it up for Zach Levine.
And played well. Well, Kobe Bryant, by the way, he's another son of a great NBA player. Joe Bryant is Kobe May.
Working on his game and is still a sponge when it comes to listening to the other greats that have come before him in the sport.
Maybe James did to, and those are things that you can learn. As you learn to get to the top of the game, and then as you start declining a bit, you've got to change your game and how to be more, start diminishing a little bit. There's always things you can keep learning.
Kobe talked about. Corey Brewer inside, gets a roll. G in this building because of the Kobe Bryant record, because of the rivalry between the Timberwolves and the Lakers, at least in the eyes of Timberwolves fans. Shabazz Muhammad finished. You're absolutely right, Jim. I mean, nothing else comes to mind. That's how big that Celtics-Lakers rivalry was. Gorgie Jang, the feed, Shabazz Muhammad.
Shabazz isn't one of those guys who's going to want to stay spotted up on the perimeter. He is going to basket cut, as will Corey Brewer.
Jordan Hill dropping it down. Levine has it knocked away.
You got to be strong with the basketball. Zach wants a foul call, but you can't do that. And Corey Brewer just gives up.
Times. Kenny Rogers. And that time, shoot 52%, 4.5 rebounds. Which was the franchise road high. Five lead changes, three ties in that opening half between the Lakers and the Timberwolves. Thad Young, as it rejects. Gorgie Jang. Wiggins with the shot clock winding down, unable to finish, but Gorgie. Timberwolves came out in the first half with a lot of intensity. Jordan Hill had a quick start to the game.
He needs to not fade on that shot. He definitely settles for that fadeaway jump shot where he needs to go up stronger than that.
Kobe underneath that Davis, no, and tapped back. Gorgie. Brewer will use the Gorgie Jang screen and then kick it for Levine. Baseline jumper for Zach. Among Wolves, one of the platforms he writes for described Shabazz Muhammad as a cannonball.
Poke away, and Andrew loses his balance. And a lot of times you do that with guys like to pull their way into the painted area. You tip all down or whatever. But that's just a savvy deep.
Nice moment earlier here at Target Center. Kobe acknowledging the crowd. Ed Davis off the heel. Thad Young will bring it up for the Wolves. Shabazz able to get Wes Johnson to fly by. It gets his own rebound and puts it back up. We told you earlier about Roni Turioff going to have arthroscopic surgery on the hip on Tuesday in New York. But there is actually perhaps some light at the end of the injury tunnel for the Wolves as Corey Brewer gets the basketball. Mo Williams not playing again tonight. Gorgie.
And they attack your closeout. Not good things happen for your team. And that time, Gorgie almost took the charge, but wasn't quite.
Realize their full potential as productive, caring, responsible citizens through programs that promote character and leadership. And Cummings' textbook shot.
Yeah, one of the post-up fall-away jump shots.
And actually did have a crack point. And listen, he'll take it any way he can get it. Flip Saunders saying before the game, he'd be fine with Kobe getting 40 tonight if the Timberwolves could get the win. He's got 15 thus far. Wiggins, no. Wes Johnson, the rebound. Kobe will wait for reinforcements. Johnson from long range. Isn't exactly a huge moment in the game either. Did give the Lakers their first double-digit lead of the night, however. Shabazz Muhammad nearly had his pocket picked by Ronnie Price.
And he contains and handles it and recomposes himself and gets an and-one opportunity.
9 of 15 now on Wiggins.
Andrew started to jump up, and then he avoided the contact, and Kobe jumped into him. Fouls is an artful. Andrew Wiggins leads Minnesota in fouls drawn with 77. Offensively, though, he does have a knack for drawing contact, and it's evidenced by the number of fouls that he's drawn. He would.
Zach LaVine does lead all rookies this season in free throw percentage. He's shooting 83% celebration and enter the ugly sweater contest for a chance to win tickets to see the Wolves host the Utah Jazz.
I got rid of all the coochie ones. I had two of them. But once I got rid of those things, then the ugly sweaters were out of my closet.
Robert Sacre denied inside. Free throw line. Knocks down the first. 6 straight games now and 8 of his last 9. And the Timberwolves closing the gap on the boards as well. Now 32-30 in favor of the Lakers. LaVine, no. Anthony Bennett.
That's what I'm talking about.
Coming into the night respectively. Timberwolves winning the battle on the offensive glass thus far. Jeremy Lin. How Zach LaVine was able to contort his body in. Hummel gets it to Shabazz, guarded by Lin, and Shabazz Muhammad yet another up in Portland. Which was the very next game the Timberwolves played after playing the Lakers when LaVine had 28 in L.A. Boozer gets a very friendly, wasn't quite as ugly. Far less important, however. Shabazz.
That's strong.
Thad Young will bring it up. Anthony Bennett, the give. Robbie Hummel, the finish. A couple of nice plays to close out the third quarter for Bennett, but still having a rough time finding the mid-range. Boozer underneath. Team. Lakers are 20 of 26, so 10 extra points make it 9 extra points. Rebounded by Gorgie. LaVine, Hummel out of the corner, and Robbie hits. Again, your chance to select the 2015 NBA All-Stars presented name, or you can vote via the NBA Game Time app from Sprint on your mobile phone. You could does have 10 in the game. Boozer underneath, able to get a couple of defenders to go. Jeremy Lin picked up by LaVine. Nick Young for 3.
Got to get out.
Round underneath.
The 4th for Gorgie Jang. He's got 4. Shabazz Muhammad has 4.
And then Gorgie putting it on the floor, getting the finish. No, but the winner. A very slow start to the game. Is the mid-range game going to come back? Not on that try.
5th offensive rebound for Gorgie Jang.
And he's 8th overall. LaVine. Right there for the putback is Anthony Hewitt.
When you're struggling, there are so many things that you can do on a basketball court. Hosting the defensive end, you get your offensive rebounds, always cutting hard, running the floor.
Shabazz Muhammad, his goal is to be an all-star. And he has shown flashes of why he believes that he can be that. And Shabazz right on cue, dropping down.
8 rebounds, too.
Ellington. He'll take the baseline jumper, misses everything. Boozer there for the putback. double-double of the season and his second in the last two games. Of course, the highlight of the night. It's a staggering number. You mentioned it earlier, Jim. Kobe Bryant, how do you know when it's your time? But ultimately, that's a personal decision. Carlos Boozer.
Build a turn, fadeaway shot. Can't do that.
Timberwolves have not led in this second half. Shabazz Muhammad. Michael Jordan gracious in issuing that statement after being passed. Kobe Bryant.
He's now in jeopardy. Still got to be aggressive.
Thad Young will take it and make it. 8 points. Bryant. Under a minute to go, and the officials called for a timeout that nobody on Dallas called for. Kind of stunted their momentum. Levine taking it to the rack, and a nice.
How much input he has on nuances of the offense. If you watch that last timeout, Kobe had a lot to say.
Kobe rattles out. Jordan Hill, no. Carlos Boozer, yes. Just 5 points for Young, who had 29 on Friday, season high against the Spurs, including that game winner. Wiggins.
Drop pick and roll coverage.
Kobe is shooting a career low from the field. Under 39% coming into the game, and just 5 of 17 tonight. Corey Brewer! In this game, he's hit on 5 of his last 13. Kobe.
Gordy's in the drop.
Wiggins, Bryant drift in traffic, and they trap him at midcourt. Gorgie Jang puts it on the floor, and the flush for Gorgie. 492 instead of 95-92, which is what it was when we went to break. During the timeout, they reviewed Wiggins' free throw. So a big momentum shift crowd in the house tonight, but largely chance for defense. Shot clock down to 6. Kobe will take it and bury it. So 4 points. Talked about it earlier, Jim. Kobe getting caught on camera with some strong words for his teammates before they.
Bryant does that all the time. I don't think that was an unusual situation for a Laker player.
Not only that, but.